Monique from Flow Flourish Yoga. Today's short flow is just a beautiful slow beginner flow, focusing on stretching out our back. So our first pose that we're going to start in is child's pose. So we have our big toes together and our knees can be spread apart, or if you want them a bit closer, they can be like that too. If you're finding it hard to sit on your heels, you can pop a block underneath your buttocks to make it a bit easier. Then we lower down and place our forehead on the mat. Again, if that's not quite for you, you can pop a block just underneath your forehead. And this is where we're going to start our practice today. So just breathing here. Breathing in through our nose and out through our nose. Trying to match your exhales with your inhales. As you inhale, inhale love. And on your exhale, exhale all hate. On your inhale, inhale courage. And on your exhale, exhale all fear. Continue breathing, letting go of all negative thoughts. Just focusing on your breath in this present moment. If you're finding it hard to let go of your thoughts, don't worry. Just acknowledge them and then let them drift away. And bring your attention back to your breath. And just repeat this whenever a thought pops into your mind. Acknowledge it and then just let it go. Don't get caught up in your to-do list and everything that you have to accomplish today. Just enjoy this moment. One last inhale and exhale. Then from child's pose, slowly lifting your head up. We're going to come to downward facing dog. So checking that your fingers are spread, your pointer fingers pointing forwards. Your hands are placed shoulder width apart. Once you have this, curling your toes, your feet are hip width apart. We're going to push up. So placing the weight into your fingertips and where your fingers join, not dropping it into your wrists. Your buttocks are pointing straight up, so we have a beautiful line from the top of our head going straight up to the sky. Your sit bones are shooting straight up, drawing those ribs in, navel to spine, relaxing those shoulders away from your ears, but your shoulder blades are wide. Just staying here for now. Then we're going to drop our knees down. Bringing our hands underneath our shoulders and our knees are under our hips. Our hands and our knees are both the same width apart. This is for our cat-cow flow. This is a beautiful flow to warm up our spine. On our inhale, we open our chest, arch our spine, and look up. On the exhale, we round our spine, drawing our chin to our chest. So inhale, opening up. Exhale, round and tuck. Inhale, relaxing the shoulders away. Exhale, lifting out of your shoulders. Inhale. Coming back to a neutral spine. Coming to downward facing dog again. Curling those back toes. Walk your hands just a little bit further forward and pushing up to downward facing dog. So checking, are your arms by your ears? Is your spine nice and long? Your sit bones straight up in the air. Relax in the shoulders. Is your navel drawing into your spine? Are your ribs knitting in? Then going to plant through those hands in the left foot, lifting the right leg up, tucking it into your chest, planting between your hands and lowering that left knee down. Then we're going to just edge that foot over a little bit and bringing our right hand onto the inside for lizard pose. If this is not feeling comfortable for you, you can grab a block or two and place them there and have your hands on that. And that just makes it a little bit easier, not so intense on your hip flexor. So again, really important to be focusing on your breath here. If this is still a bit too intense, you can just bring your hips back a bit more, and then that's less intense. You want to be making sure that your knee is still over your right ankle, that it's not moving out to the side. So just staying here. Enjoying this moment of just being still, being thankful for what your body can do, what it is capable of, not judging it, just being present and being grateful for everything it does. And just removing those blocks to the side, you are using them. Planting those hands, curling the back toe, we're going to step back again to downward facing dog. Planting through the hands on the right foot, lift that left leg, drawing it in, planting between your hands, lowering the right knee down. Again, just edge it over just a little bit. Bringing the left hand onto the inside. And again, if you need those blocks, placing them there. Again, if it's still a bit too intense, just pull those hips back a little bit. And breathing. If you're finding it hard to concentrate here, you can focus on your breath by counting. We breathe in for six, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, pause, exhale for 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you can continue that cycle. If you're struggling with breathing in and exhaling for 6, you can just lower the count to 4, find whatever is best for you. Sometimes when we count our breath, that just helps us to have something to focus on, to ignore everything that is around us and all the thoughts going on in our minds. And just removing the blocks to the side. And again, curling the back toes, stepping back to downward facing dog. And I'm going to bend on these little toe hands, and you can just step your feet up to either side behind your hands. So they're a bit wider now than hip width apart, and this is yogi squat. So you can be on the balls of your feet, or if it's comfortable, lowering all the way down. The block can be used here again, sliding it under your buttocks. So you're not just dumping all the weight into it. You still want to be putting the weight and balancing in your hips, but it's just, balancing in your feet. But it's just a little bit of an aid, just to keep you a bit stable here. Again, you can have your fingertips out in front of you, or bring them to your heart in prayer pose, and your elbows just push on the inside of your knees, pushing apart. You can also use the other side of the block, so the higher side, if that's where you might be. That's the great thing about yoga, is that there's so many ways to modify to help our body into the pose. We always need to be listening to our body, not pushing it into poses that it's not ready for, as that will just cause more problems. So again, here the spine is nice and long. So that's one of the key alignments in so many poses, is making sure that your spine's nice and long. There are times when we do round it. So like in yogi squat, you could walk your hands out in front of you, stretching out a bit more. If that's something that feels good for you, you can slowly drop the head. But otherwise, if you're sitting up, making sure that your core and ribs are drawing in and your spine's nice and long. Okay, then removing that block if you are using it, slowly making your way down onto the floor. So coming into butterfly pose now, bringing the soles of your feet together. The further your feet are away from your body, the easier the pose. So if you would like a bit more of a challenge or a stretch, bring them in a bit closer. Just working out what's best for you, making sure you might want to just lift up and down, making sure that you're sitting right on your sit bones so that then your spine goes up nice and long. If you're sitting a bit further back, then you can't get that nice long spine, it rounds. So that's something that's really important. You might like to just lift up and down, checking and breathing here. Not forcing our knees down. As we sit in this pose, our hips begin to relax and they will lower down a bit more. You can stay here, or if you would like, you can walk your hands out a little bit more, slowly bending down. And on our inhales, lengthen our spine. And on the exhale, and lower a bit more. So using your breath to work into the poses. So inhale, lengthen. Exhale, lower down. lifting your head, slowly walking, nice hands back. We're going to make our way onto our back. So just slowly moving down with your feet planted in the ground. Bring them a bit closer so that if you reach your hands down, you can kind of tickle the back of your foot. Making sure that they're hip width apart. We want our lower back to be pressing into the ground. We're going to take our right knee to our chest, bring it to our chest, and then the outside of the right ankle is going to come onto your left left thigh. Your right toes are flexed as this helps to protect your knee. So this here might be enough of a stretch. Okay, making sure that your lower back's pressing into the ground, so shoulders are into the ground as well. If you'd like more of a stretch here, you can use a scarf or a strap to kind of wrap around your left shin or under the back of your knee. If you don't need that, you can do it with your hands, just linking around. And this is recline pigeon. So it's a beautiful pose. Works into your lower back, also works into your hips and buttocks. So just checking that your shoulders are relaxed and into the ground. Using your stomach, your core pushing into the ground as well. So even though these poses are nice and slow and relaxing, we still want to have our muscles engaged and we're still using them. We're not just relaxing everything, not having anything engaged, because that won't help at all. Maybe releasing your hands if you took that modification. And then we're just going to let our right thigh and knee drop down for a bit of a twist. Checking that your shoulders are still pressing into the ground. And then you might like to use your hand to bring it up. Swapping over, so checking your feet are planted hip width apart, can you touch them? Keeping that right foot into the ground, lift your leg, your left leg into your chest, and then the outer left ankle onto your right thigh, keeping your toes flexed. And again, here might be what you do today, or if you'd like a bit more of a deeper stretch, you can use a strap or a scarf or your hands, thinking around the shin or behind the knee, inner knee. And again, shoulders relaxing, staying on the ground, your navel's drawing to your spine, making sure that your lower back is pressing into the ground. And just bringing your attention back to your breath. Inhaling and exhaling. Matching them. Feeling your breath rise all the way from your stomach up to your upper chest. And then exhaling it all out with a little squeeze in your stomach. Slowly release, letting that right foot come down, and then letting your left thigh and knee slowly drop to the side for a little bit of a twist. using it to push back up. Bringing both knees into your chest. Your low back pressing into the ground. Always want a low back pressing into the ground. And rocking from side to side. This next pose is one of my favorite lower back stretches. There are some modifications for it. So to begin with, we want to take our knees apart. Then what we're going to do is we're going to put our feet up like they're walking on the ceiling. And this might be where you are today. You might take your hands behind your knees and just kind of pull them down a little bit. Or you could use some straps, put them over the arch of your foot and hold them. You may be able to grab your ankles and sway a little from side to side. Or if you can, keeping your arms on the inside of your knees, then grabbing the outside of your foot and pulling them down. Again, your lower back is against the ground, pushing down. Your core is on. And you might just rock a little bit side to side, not a big one. So on. And then just staying here, relaxing the shoulders into the ground. Your core is on and pressing down. You should be able to feel a beautiful stretch in your lower back and also in your hips. And this is happy baby. Just letting go. Any tension you feel in your body. Inhaling and exhale. Let it go. And slowly releasing the grip on your hand. Bringing your knees back together, lowering down, coming to our final resting pose. So extending your legs out here. Oh, crack. And just getting comfortable. So letting your feet drop to the side, flexing the shoulders, arms out to the side with your palms facing up, fingers curled in. And just feeling your body sink into the ground. Relaxing your brows. Relaxing your mouth. Your tongue, feel your shoulders just sink into the ground, away from your ears, your tension slowly moving from your body, moving all the way down, your buttocks against the ground, your legs relaxing, releasing. And all tension going out your toes, releasing from your body. Just be here in this moment, grateful for this moment of peace, grateful for what your body did today, for what it is capable of. And you can stay here for as long as you like. And when you're ready to finish, just take this feeling off your mat and out into your day.